today, after the terrorist attack in Orlando, Florida, you're going to look across Facebook and it's going to be covered in memes, videos, articles, pictures, people's, just feelings on the matter, all kinds of shared sentiment. But most people that I associate with, it's very clear, they understand the problem in a very clear way. But I do want to say this: not all Muslims are bad people. That's just a fact of life, it's a reality. Some of the nicest people I've ever met were Muslims. Guy that I'm driving with right now, teaching, he's a Muslim. One of the nicest guys I've ever met. He came to this country legally. He is a good person. I don't know his past that well, and I don't know what he's been through or what he has planned for the future other than helping his family and becoming a successful person here in the United States, from what he's told me. Not all Muslims are bad, but there is a particular problem. We need to secure our borders. Regardless of, the way we are perceived, no other country in the world is as lenient as the United States. Being that we are the most successful country in the world, I find that to be, kind of bizarre. That other countries don't have nearly the success as we do, and they are definitely less lenient. And they do that because they know that they can't take the strain of mass immigration. And these countries that are taking in mass immigration, they are starting to have problems. We are on the precipice of huge global conflict. Multinational corporations and government agencies and government entities want that to happen. Everywhere you look, you can see the signs, you can see the structure being built, TPP, the other, trade agreement, all these big international structures, Bilderberg just met in Germany. They're all looking, internet ID, all these different multinational ideas are basically the building blocks for what everybody has said, regardless if you think it's conspiracy theory sounding or not. New World Order. And it is a plan that they have been formulating for a long time. Because once they have a global corporate structure, everybody loses sovereignty, and they can use media manipulation to get whatever laws they want passed. The current president of the United States of America does not want you to be able to defend yourself. Hillary Clinton does not want you to be able to defend yourself from threats, foreign and domestic. These people openly preach about national, global policies that will take away your freedom, that will take away our ability to reach our own happiness. Take away people's wealth and redistribute it to people that do not deserve it, that have not earned it themselves. Get the word out. Speak to people. Get out there and let other people know. For too long, people have been silent, have been passive, and letting this country be sold, taken away from us, destroyed in a way. People attacked in the streets of California for wanting to get rid of illegals, technically criminals, that came here in an unethical way, in an illegal way, and taken away from everyone else here. And I can say that openly because I am a legal immigrant to this country. First generation, was born in Brazil, immigrated here legally, did the process legally. It was expensive, it took time, but that's what you're supposed to do. Is it broken? Is it a broken system? Yes, it is. It needs reform, like a lot of things in this country need reform. But this is a country, and as a country, it needs to defend its borders and its people. Bless America.